Thank you. I don't look outside myself for answers. I kind of feel like everyone has a voice of reason inside, and I believe that's been quelled to a large degree.
Who knew Lindsay, or perhaps you called her Binny or Lintendo, or another familiar term of endearment, but each of you who knew her were touched by her many gifts. All who saw her, of course, saw her beauty with their eyes, but you, her family and her friends, experienced the beauty of her very spirit to your hearts. Beauty is a sense of wonder. It's an admiration for the harmony, color, and loveliness of the world. It allows us to feel our connectedness to all of creation. It calls us to look beyond a superficial appearance to appreciate what is within. And Lindsay's beauty was within as much as it ever was without. It was a unique expression of her nature and her gifts, of which she had many. I'd like to call up Cindy, her aunt, to share the eulogy, and we'll hear stories that reflect of many of Lindsay's gifts of character. And then Vanessa will come and share with us a poem and a tribute that she's written.
Good afternoon. My name is Cindy Johnston. It'll take me a minute. I'm Lindsay's second cousin. Laura and I actually grew up like sisters. So Lindsay, big sister Carly, and little brother Brennan know me as Auntie Cindy. I'd like to thank everybody for coming today in person and online, supporting the family and joining us for Lindsay's celebration of life. She's gone way too soon and left a space that will never be filled. Lindsay Jennifer Reynolds, a beautiful girl, a gentle soul, and a kind heart. She was born on Friday the 13th of March, 1992, an absolute Halloween lover. She always joked that her day of birth was pretty fitting for her. The family chose this day, Halloween, on purpose for her. She was raised on an acreage in the county of Grand Prairie on the banks of the Wapiti River. When Lindsay was little, she loved to play with her Barbies and dress up with Carly. She changed her outfits several times a day, pretending to be a princess or whatever her imagination could come up with. Living close to the river, Lindsay was a fearless adventurer, spent as much time there as she could. In the summer, they would explore on quads and get pulled along in the wagon by Dad. In the winter, they were having fun on snowmobiles and toboggans. Brennan said Lindsay was the bravest out of them all. She was always the first to jump in the cold lake or river, try new foods, anything. She was up for an adventure. I clearly remember a day when I was visiting. We were in the kitchen, and she was squirming in her chair, fighting her math homework. And she wanted to be outside with Carly, Brennan, and the cousins on the quads. It was the cousins' first time seeing quads. Laura knew that she was losing the homework battle, so she set her free to run wild with them. She was at her best outdoors. She took mud baths and enjoyed countless wiener roasts by the river with family and friends. Lindsay also loved to skate and ski at the local hill. The family made a few trips to Jasper and Powder King. Larry took pictures of the river trail this week, and his first thought was to share them with Lindsay. There won't be a single trip to the river where she isn't remembered. When she was about 14, Laura and Grandma Mavis brought all three kids to Vancouver to visit us. She had so many friends and connections at Lindsay, and it took her what seemed like 5 minutes to connect with somebody on Facebook and meet up with them. She was 14. She was always connected to everybody, and you were lucky if she counted you as one of her friends. I don't know if she truly understood what an influence she was on other people, even at a young age. During the same visit to Vancouver, she asked her cousin Riley what there was to do in town. She was always on the move. He mentioned a new local skate park, and she jumped up and said, "Well, let's get going." He was amazed when they got there how fearless she was. She introduced herself to each little group, didn't matter how old or how young, while she was bumming smokes. Today, Riley said he would never have had the courage to get involved in the skate scene if it hadn't been for Lindsay that day. He's visited that park several times a week for the last 15 years. Skating, making lifelong friends like she showed him. Now, he owns a business selling skate gear and vintage clothing. We thank you, Lindsay, for that day of bold courage and your love for adventure. You absolutely changed lives wherever you were. Several people in Calgary told Laura that Lindsay's encouragement was the reason that they had become photographers and models. She really wanted everybody to pursue their dreams. As she grew up, she was a classic country girl who loved camping, quadding, the annual fishing derby at Moonshine Lake. She was as comfortable in rubber boots and mud as she was in high heels and lipstick. She had her limits, though. She went to Bear Lake Bible Camp for many summers. In her last year, though, she told her mom she wasn't going back. There's too many moths in the outhouse, so she was having none of it. If you knew Lindsay, you knew her love for horses. She volunteered at Pards, took riding lessons, and eventually owned her own horse, Maggie. Together, they joined a private 4-H group and excelled at English horse jumping. She earned lots of ribbons that we have out there at the front. She was a very proud rider. Her love of animals was endless, and she especially loved her babies, her cats. She had cat ornaments, cat blankets, cat clothing, cat jewelry. One of her favorite movies of all time is Disney's Aristocats. Some of her cats were rescued from Bandaged Paws here in Grand Prairie, which is taking donations in her memory. In returning from Calgary, her cat Rang has learned to be a country cat once again. He's doing really well, going outside, picking on his brother, and he's become a novice cat bird killer. After spending this week with Rang, it's easy to tell how completely loved and pampered he was by Lindsay. He is always asking for pets and scratches that he was used to. He loves to sit on your lap and just purr and hug you. You could tell he was loved. Lindsay graduated from Peace Wapiti Academy in 2010, and she was a shining example of determination when she completed her healthcare aid certificate in 2012. Teachers told her she would never have a mind for math, but she showed them. She was a very clever, resourceful girl, more than most people imagined or even gave her credit for. She worked in a hospital until 2017 when she moved to Calgary. She continued to work as an HCA and the huge Calgary drop-in center that was there. She loved her healthcare job, but her true passions led her elsewhere. Her dad bought Lindsay her very first camera, and it fed her creativity and proved to change her life. She even created her own company, Lynn's Photography, where she was a photographer for weddings, other special occasions, photo shoots with everybody that she could think of. On the back of your little handouts, there's a picture of lipsticks and red lips. And some of us are wearing red lips in her honor today because that was her trademark. One of the first images she ever took a picture of was of the lipsticks on the back of the card. She worked with local photographers. She did live figure modeling for local artists at the Grand Prairie Creative Arts Center. She traveled to Edmonton for various photo shoots and as a calendar model. Lindsay was a very busy girl. When she was just 16, her and a friend created a club where they would do hair and makeup for the younger girls. They'd take pictures of them, and their main goal was to raise their self-esteem. She always thought of everybody else. Lindsay worked to pursue a career in fashion, modeling, acting, and photography. We knew she would do modeling one day. Even when she was little, if she wasn't in a princess dress or some other creative outfit, she was naked. You couldn't keep clothes on that girl. During the summer, you could spot her in a crowd of kids because she was the only one with a tanned bum. Whether you appreciated her form of art or not, she was a confident, beautiful woman who was strong enough to put herself out there and do what she loved. She brought photographers and models together to have fun, hone their skills, and share their passion. She loved what she did. She has worked to build a huge portfolio of gorgeous professional photos, participated in numerous fashion shows, acted in videos, and was a proud contestant in the International Bikini Search. She was a leader in the Trade for Photos community in Calgary, wherein she encouraged and inspired so many people to go after their dreams. Scores of people in Calgary turned out for a memorial photo shoot where they have created an annual event to be held in her honor. It's called the Lindsay Reynolds Memorial Collaboration. They just finished year one with family there. This community of photographers and models meant the world to her. During the last year, while working in Calgary, she was a support worker for the Calgary Drop-In Center, like I said. Through her life experiences, she could empathize and really help these people. She became their advocate when they needed her the most. She had her struggles, no doubt, but she battled hard and was still always eager to help others without judgment. She was also a volunteer for the nonprofit organization Change the Face of Addiction. Their mission is to create conversations that educate, communicate, and connect communities to overcome the stigma associated with substance abuse. You know, this disease touches every one of us, through family, friends, or coworkers. It's everywhere, it's all around us. And under certain circumstances, any one of us could fall prey to that, any one of us. No one intends to go there. Addiction creeps up on people slowly without even seeing it. For many of us, it's hard to understand, but it's better to learn and listen than walk away. Lenny, we will miss you for all of your days, all of our days, but you're free from your demons now and will watch over us with bedazzled wings. I know you're still helping others in that next place, all with your cats by your side. We're proud of your ability to touch and inspire others, passing on your wisdom and compassion. Your beauty will live on, and you can be sure you are now the brightest star in the sky. I won't say goodbye to you, just until we meet again. I know that you're in that next place with your irresistible smile, welcoming new souls to join you on this next adventure. Thank you for sharing your life with us. We are all the better for it, and we love you. I have a poem here that's important to all of us, but mostly to Larry. It's called Memories, and the author is unknown. They say memories are golden. Well, maybe that is true, but we never wanted memories, we only wanted you. A million times we've needed you, a million times we've cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we love you still. In our hearts, you hold a special place no one could ever fill. If tears could build a staircase and heartache could build a lane, we'd walk the path to heaven and bring you back again. Our family chain. Our family chain is broken, and nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, the chain will link again. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Vanessa. Bear with me. I'm going to try to get through this. Lindsay was my little Binnie. I started babysitting her and Carly when they first moved out to Riverview Pines Subdivision. Our family's relationship moved quickly from neighbors to friends, and friends to family. Lindsay was such a happy little baby. She was so bright-eyed and was taking the whole world in. And that never changed when she became mobile either. I remember on many of her quadding trips to the river, she would get off the quad, start stripping those clothes off. Sorry. And she'd be running around half naked, digging in the sand, either looking for something or just seeing what she could find. She was always looking for an adventure. And we'd wander through the trees or we'd go looking for bugs and water puddles. She was never afraid to get dirty or approach any critter, because Lindsay always had a deep love for animals. She had hamsters, cats, dogs, ferrets, horse. She was a very loving and gentle soul, And I remember thinking when she was about 2 years old that this girl is a free, nature-loving little firecracker. And she did not like restrictions or being told that she couldn't. She always knew what she wanted, even if it didn't meet the status quo. And I often think that was a gift she gave us right from a toddler. The memories go on and on because we had many family dinners and Christmas celebrations together. The Reynolds would come over and my mom would play Christmas carols on the piano and the girls and Brennan would sing with us. You brought the magic back into our house for years. We turned the radio on so we could track Santa. I just remember it being so much fun watching her light up. In the summers, we'd all spend many weekends together camping at my parents' lake property. Lindsay loved it out there. She was exploring and swimming, roasting marshmallows and quadding and tubing. I even took her and Carly and my cousin Ashley out there by myself one weekend. They were just so fun to be around that that's what my 17-year-old self wanted to do. I loved them. She had become a little sister to me. As life went on, we were called to different journeys. I moved away for college, and then I started a family of my own. By the time I moved back, Lindsay was an adult starting her own adventures. But we had the chance to reconnect this summer at my parents' lake property again, and it was amazing. And I'm so grateful that we had that time. And in true compassionate Lindsay fashion, even though she was there to relax on her vacation, she took my 14-year-old daughter, Haley, under her wing, and they did a photo shoot together. My daughter expressed an interest in modeling, and Lindsay was on it. I don't know if I ever told her how much that meant to me, but it was very special, and I appreciated her so much. I know I speak for my parents and myself when I say Lindsay was special. She was family, and she will be remembered forever with so much love as our little Binny. I've written a little poem for her here too. It's called A Gift. A gift from above, all wrapped in pink. A gift from the heavens, I surely would think. 10 little fingers and 10 little toes, a beautiful bright smile and a cute little nose. She blessed our world with fire and grace. She encouraged us all to never stand in one place. Keep moving and growing, find who you are. For in each of us, Lindsay saw a great star. She knew what it took to be humble and kind. She knew the restrictions she had to unwind. For free and expressive is where she wanted to be, not locked down into conformity. She knew her own soul from a very young age. She wrote her own story. She filled every page. She had passion and heart, and she gave it her all, and she never backed down when life came to call. She was courageous and brave, and she shared it around. She had a kindness about her that was just so profound. The impact she made in the lives that she touched showed us her strength was that she loved us all so much. Thank you for fighting to stay this long. Thank you for teaching us to sing our own song. Thank you for being our bright shining star. Thank you for being the gift that you are. Rest easy, my Binny, for now you are free. Thank you for sharing all of you with me.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, everybody. So today is my last day of work before I go home for my holidays. Yay, last day of work. Then it is vacation time.
What a treasure it is to pull together stories and beautiful photos and video like that to this picture of this beautiful young woman. It's difficult to capture in a few words the depth of this woman. She was optimistic and determined and passionate and purposeful. She was full of awe and enthusiasm and humanity, hope and cooperation. These all came to mind as I was preparing my remarks today. And then the poem that Vanessa wrote added passion, bravery, humility, and strength to that list. We could be here all day, without a doubt. But I have picked out a few qualities that I'd like to take a moment to highlight. That's Lindsay's authenticity, her helpfulness, her kindness, her courage, charity, idealism, and her vision. Lindsay was unapologetically herself, whether in heels or in muddy boots, eating chocolate or modeling bikinis. Authenticity is when the things that we think and feel and say match and reflect in our actions. It requires us first to be truthful with ourselves. With truth to ourselves, we can then harbor a spirit that allows others to trust us also. Lindsay took responsibility for the commitments and statements she made, knowing that they truly aligned with her values. Authenticity is truth in action. And in countless ways, Lindsay's actions went straight into her gift of helpfulness. Helpfulness is doing useful things for others, things that make a difference to them, no matter how small. It's taking the time to be thoughtful, reflecting on what people truly need, and assisting them respectfully. As a care aide, Lindsay worked long hours in difficult situations and without complaint. Lindsay worked selflessly to benefit the lives of others. And in doing so, she was blessed in her life. Now, many people can be helpful, but few do so with the kindness that Lindsay displayed. Kindness is caring that springs from compassion. Lindsay had genuine concern for the welfare of others. She was warm, friendly, and ready to help. She listened for the needs of others that were beneath the words they said and she gave tender attention in simple ways that brought others happiness. She also used her gifts to be of service, which is another gift. Each day she found a multitude of ways to be useful. She knew that the quality of our own lives comes from the quality of our contribution to the lives of others. She instinctively knew that. She noticed what others needed. She discovered their wishes and she responded helpfully. Lindsay did not wait to be asked. A spirit of service invests whatever we do with excellence, and it certainly did for Lindsay. People who want to be of service can change the world. Lindsay's acts of service were enhanced by her gift of courage, which she showed even as a child when she approached a barking, tough-looking dog with open arms to hug the cute puppy. And when she spent a night stranded on the riverbank, or by always being the first to jump into a pool, no matter how cold it was. And she did so in boldly sharing her story to change the face of addiction. That courage transforms fear into determination. It's embracing life fully without holding back and doing what must be done, even when it's difficult or risky. When we're tempted to give up, courage supports us to take the next step. Her courage allowed Lindsay to face adversity with confidence. It opened her up to new possibilities and gave her the strength to pursue and achieve the things that she loved. And she gave back to others wholeheartedly. That is her gift of charity. Charity is a giving heart, a generous way of viewing others and caring for their needs. Charity springs from compassion for the suffering of others and even those we don't know. Charity moved Lindsay to respond to the needs of others, giving help and encouragement whenever she saw the chance to. She made a genuine difference in lives. Her active connections and her drive in the Trade for Print community and in the Lindsay Reynolds Memorial Collaboration are examples of her charity made manifest, and they will live on. Through her gift of charity, Lindsay created ever-expanding circles of love, vision, and idealism. Idealism is having a vision of what's possible and wanting to make a difference. It's caring passionately about what's meaningful in life and having faith in the power of change. Lindsay didn't accept things just the way they were. She dared to have big dreams and believe they were possible. Now, idle dreamers just wish that things were better. But Lindsay, being a true idealist, did something to make things better. She made the ideal real for herself and many others that she encouraged along the way. Her idealism and her vision opened doors for the people of the lives she touched. Vision allowed Lindsay to see things as they could be. She built bridges between opportunities and creating roads of inspiration for those around her. She dared to dream big, and she intuitively understood how to ground ideas and connect them with others. Not having action prevents inspirational ideas from becoming true, but visionary people communicate and empower others to walk along with them. Visionaries are the propagators of hope and the inspiration that propels themselves and others to new heights. Lindsay shared these gifts so freely with every one of you. Authenticity, her beauty, her helpfulness, her kindness, courage, charity, idealism, and her vision, and so many more gifts that I didn't mention. And your lives are better for it. You carry her with you through her impact on your lives with the gifts she shared with you. So as you notice these gifts in others, take a moment to remember Lindsay, your child, your sister, your friend. And as you practice these gifts in your own lives, do so in Lindsay's memory. As we close today, I'm going to invite everyone who's here to spend a moment writing out your favorite memories of Lindsay, or perhaps a few, in the gallery. And there's a box to put them into. Our attendants will show you. I'm sure those stories will be a comfort to Lindsay's family in the coming days as they face a world without Lindsay, but one that's made brighter for her presence having been in your lives. And memorial donations. In the true way that Lindsay did things to help, memorial donations can be made to change the face of addiction and to bandage paws. Lindsay's family will join you after saying a private farewell here in Peace Hall. And then you're invited to an open house at Carly's home, and we'll have the address for you. In closing, I've selected a stanza from Vanessa's poem. And it was called The Gift. Lindsay, thank you for being our bright, shining star. Thank you for being the gift that you are. Let's close in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for that gift that Lindsay was in the lives of those, everyone she touched. As you take her now into your tender care and leave with those left behind the memories of her goodness and passion and everything that she brought to their lives, give comfort to them in those memories as they go on in a life, a world that was made brighter for Lindsay's presence, but is now left with her memory. In your name we pray this. Amen.
Never behind you. The life behind you. The life behind you. The life behind you.
Thank you.